dear students, we have understood about the chapter A Question of Trust from our supplementary reader Footprints Without Feet. Now today we will do the read and find out question answer, think about it and talk about it. So question number one is, what does Horace Danby like to collect? Answer: Horace Danby likes to collect rare and expensive books. Question number two, why does he steal every year? Answer: he steals every year so that he could buy the rare and expensive books that he loved to collect. Each year he planned carefully so as to steal enough money for 12 months. Third question, who is speaking to Horace Danby? Answer: a lady standing in the doorway is speaking to Horace Danby. She was young, pretty and was dressed in red. She said that she had come just in time but didn't expect to meet a burglar. Thus, she pretended to be one of the members of the family living at Shootover Grange. Question number four, who is the real culprit in the story? Answer: the real culprit in the story is the woman in the red dress who pretended to be a member of the family living at Shootover Grange. She tricked Horace Danby into believing her and cleverly took away all the jewels that were kept in the safe. Now next, think about it. Did you begin to suspect before the end of the story that the lady was not the person Horace Danby took her to be? If so, at what point did you realize this and how? Yes, we begin to suspect before the end of the story that the lady was not the person Horace Danby took her to be. She was unusually calm on seeing Horace. This seemed strange. When she did not call the police and instead asked Horace to take out all the jewels from the safe, seems suspicious. Moreover, it seemed highly unlikely that she would forget the number to open the safe. Therefore, it was evident before the story ended that the lady was not the person as per the thought of Horace. Question number two, what are the subtle way in which the lady manages to deceive Horace Danby into thinking she is the lady of the house? Why doesn't Horace suspect that something is wrong? Answer: the lady's confident walk, her familiarity with the dog Sherry, her act of touching up her makeup, and the ease with which she picks a cigarette from the right place are enough to deceive Horace into thinking that she was the lady of the house. Horace does not suspect anything as he was too to think properly. Question number three, Horace Danby was good and respectable but not completely honest. Why do you think this description is apt for Horace? Why can't he be categorized as a typical thief? Now, Horace Danby was good and respectable but not completely honest in an apt description for Horace. He was a respectable lockmaker who had good reputation in the society. But Horace was also an unusual thief. He had a hobby of collecting rare and expensive books, which he fulfilled by robbing a safe every year. Thus, he was not a completely honest man. Horace cannot be categorized as a typical thief because he was not a regular offender. He robbed once a year and only took what was required. Question number four. Horace Danby was a meticulous planner but still he flattered. Where did he go wrong and why? Answer: it is true that Horace Danby was a meticulous planner, but he had flattered in the robbery he was carrying out in Shootover Grange. This failure was because of the lady in red who deceived the tricked Horace into believing that she was the lady of the house. Horace, who had carefully planned the robbery, did not care to get any information about the housemates. Consequently, he blindly believed that the lady in red was the lady of the house. So when she suddenly appeared, Horace carelessly opened the safe without his gloves. Now talk about it, page number 25. Do you think Horace Danby was unfairly punished or that he deserved what he got? Answer: I think Horace Danby deserved what he got. A crime is a crime, no matter if it is committed for your own benefit or for somebody else's benefit. Question number 2, do intentions justify actions? Would you like Horace Denby do something wrong if you thought your ends justified the means? Do you think that there are situations in which it is excusable to act less than honestly? Answer, ends do not justify means is a very old and time-tested saying. To reach one's own profitable or good end, one should never harm others. Our intentions never justify our means. Horace Denby, by opening a safe, wanted to help a lady. But in his act, Horace forgot that he was committing a crime and thus was caught by the police. When we then must remember that a crime is crime no matter the intentions. Now, unlike Horace Denby, I would never do something wrong if the end justified the means. So students, here we complete our question answer of our lesson number, a question of trust. So you have to write all these answers in your notebook and learn it.